Alright guys, welcome to the video. Right now what I'm going to do is take you through me getting my stuff from MYPROTEIN and doing a very good in-depth haul that I'm going to try on for you guys. Hopefully you enjoy the review. I'm going to go over the quality of it, the sizing of it, my height as well so you can kind of compare, and what you overall think of the actual item itself. I personally, you know what, I don't want to spoil it. Cue the intro. What is good peeps? Right now what we're going to do is do a MYPROTEIN clothing haul, because I saw a whole bunch of clothing on the MYPROTEIN website and then like loads and loads and loads of discounts, so I thought why not buy some. I ended up buying like two massive boxes worth of clothing, so I'm going to talk about my sizing and whatnot. But right now what I'm going to do is collect the clothing. I don't know why they've been lying, but your shit is not that inspiring. Bank account statement just look like I'm ready for early retirement. Fuck any nigga that's talking that shit just to get a reaction. Alright people, now we're going to get into the review. I've got two big boxes for MYPROTEIN, so I'm going to review these, give you guys a sizing guide. As a heads up, I am 5'7", currently around 168 pounds, so just for you to keep a reference. Alright, so I'm going to break them open now, if I could find a key or a knife or something. Alright, so we're going to break this open. A lot of people don't realise that. There is obviously Gymshark, ALPHALETE and loads of other clothing companies out there. But I will say MYPROTEIN is usually quite affordable and the stuff is pretty good. I've been rocking with them for years. Okay, I also got myself a little bit of treats to eat as well, because your boy needs gains. Fuck going platinum, I looked at my wrist and it's already platinum. I am the kid with the motor mouth, I am the one you should worry about. I don't know who you're referring to, who is this nigga you heard about? Alright, in addition to all the clothing I've just shown you guys, I've just bought, this is one of the ones I already have. So some of the new items that I've previously bought months ago, I'll show you guys as well. And to start off, this is a size small and I think it fits perfect and it's really good. They have the option to do these hand things. I personally am not a fan of those, so I usually take it out. It's quite fitted. Still breathable though, so it's not like super tight on your body. It looks fitted, but if you need to breathe, you're a little bit bigger. Trust me, there is space for you to grow. It just kind of bounces back. If you don't want to wear it like this, or you feel like it's a bit too much, what I often do as well, sometimes. So this is usually what I'd wear to the gym if I don't feel comfortable just wearing the full grey. As it feels still fitting on my arms, it's really, really comfortable. But I also have the option to obviously, because the top's kind of thin, if you've got nipples showing through, you may not like that, or you don't want the core to look too fitted. So this is another option of how you can wear it. What I'm going to do now is take you through those clothings and show you guys some of the new stuff I've got. You know what, let's start with the hoodies. So what I'm going to go for is the green hoodie first. In terms of the size on this, this is a size medium that I've bought. Oh, this is just the sleeveless. I thought it was the full hoodie. As you can see, it looks pretty good. This is a medium size. Very, very, very breathable. The quality of it is pretty good. It's not like super thin. If anything, I probably could have got away with a small in this, but this is perfectly fine. Alright, and here we have the red and grey. I love this one. You can tell that I kind of like the sleeveless things, they're pretty cool. Plus, I really like the red and grey, especially as I've worn the grey under top. So therefore, it makes it like it's almost a hoodie, which looks pretty damn good. I'll probably show you guys the pullovers again when I have no undersleeve on at the end of the video. Just so you can kind of see if you want to like the style, if you like the gaps and stuff like that. But I like this one, I really like it. I probably prefer this one to the olive and black one. Next up, here is the black, and this is an example of how they fit when you're not wearing the sleeved arms. As you can see, it still lets you have space, shows off the gains. This part here isn't too far low. I know some tops are like the really far down, so they show the lats. This one's the average sized armhole. I personally feel like the softness of the quality of the clothes is really, really good. This is one of the reasons I'm doing this review, because I know a lot of people always ask me to review Gymshark like I used to, or ALPHALETE, and loads of other big name clothing brands when it comes to fitness. But I do like their clothing, but one thing that people always overlook is MYPROTEIN's website. They have sales all the time. Like all the stuff I've bought right now was 2-for-1, and I purposely, with MYPROTEIN, which is going to be a tip to you guys, when they come out with a new item, don't buy it straight away. Wait like 2 months, because they sell out of stuff pretty quick. They do crazy mad sales just to get rid of the last bits of stock. So when I see a new item at MYPROTEIN, for example this and some of the other pullovers, I purposely waited I think 2.5 months, because I knew they were going to have some ridiculous sale, because they always do it. I never bought one supplement or one piece of clothing from MYPROTEIN for the full price, because they always do 2-for-1 or 30% off, 20% off, 10% off. I even have a discount code for them, which is in the description box, which is always year round 10% off. It's pure muscle 10. So yeah, that is a big tip. So if you want to buy decent clothing, decent quality clothing, for an affordable price, check out MYPROTEIN. You might find something you like. Alright, let's switch it up. I totally forgot I actually bought joggers, so let's try the joggers on. The joggers I have got, these are size medium and these are just the standard joggers. I'm not a super fan of like the normal kind of slim fit I normally get like here. These are more the skinny type of fit, which I feel like are a little bit too thin. So I purposely went and bought some joggers because they are much thicker. These are what I bought last time for MYPROTEIN, and they were like really skinny kind of fit. But the problem with them is that they're quite thin, which means that they can be quite revealing, especially in the crotch area, like when you're working out and stuff. As many times I've filmed myself for my YouTube channel, and when I'm wearing these trousers, you can just see the bulge and stuff. It's not really a good look, and I don't like it when I'm around the gym and stuff. Some might, you might like it, but I personally, I don't like my clothing being too thin when it comes to trousers. All right, you saw me wear the gray earlier. Now we've got the blue, and I'm also wearing the gray joggers just to give you a comparison of how it looks. These MYPROTEIN joggers, I'm gonna tell you right now, are so comfy. They are legit the softest joggers that I've worn in God knows how long, on the quality of like Nike and Adidas when it comes to joggers. They're really thick, nice fleece joggers, and they're really warm and much more of a preference. And you don't see no crazy bulges and stuff when I'm working out in them. So I really am a massive fan of these. Let me step back so you can kind of see them a bit more. Here you go, this is kind of fit, how it looks. So yeah, they are just your standard straight cut kind of joggers. I personally feel like they're really comfortable. The only thing is that I would have liked to maybe tapered the bottom part a slight bit. Not skinny fit, but just tapered it enough that it's more like a slim fit kind of range. Hopefully they'll do that. All right guys, now I've got two tops, the exact same type. The only difference I did is I purposely bought one in small and one in medium, just so you guys can kind of see the different fit on someone like me. So I'm gonna try on the small first, and then I'll go on the medium, which is the green. Remember, I'm 5'7", 168 pounds right now. For most of these I already own already, I had the small, and I have a feeling that small was probably the correct sizing. Oh, I love this red color. I really like the red with the, I don't even know what it's called when it's like that. Is it marl effect? The red marl looks pretty good. See, this fits perfect, so I almost know that the medium is probably gonna be a bit too baggy for me, but on cardio days, I don't mind. And this is the green in medium. It honestly is not that bad. You can see here, the only difference is that it kind of hangs lower on you. So in terms of the arms, it's because they're already fitting, as long as you got a little bit of gains, it'll still hug the sleeves and that's everything's fine. The actual feeling of the clothing is really comfortable, it's really soft. Show you the thickness. It's a very soft clothing, feels really good on your body. This one's just probably a bit more breathable. But this one, I will say, a medium would be great. If you're someone like me, I do a lot of hanging leg exercises and stuff like that. So when you raise your arms, it's not gonna like great, see, it's not even moving, which is the good thing about getting one size up. So this is partly one of the reasons why I bought the medium as well. One was to make sure you guys kind of see a different kind of size, but two was because when I'm doing my leg raises, knee raises, oblique windshield wipers, all those stuff I do in my gym videos, sometimes the top kind of raises up and it just kind of makes it look crap. So at least with having something medium, now when I raise my arms and do those exercises, the top's gonna stay in perfect proportion. All right, and this is the last thing I've got, which is the red hoodie with the black and gray arms. Personally, I think it feels great. This is a size small. It does feel quite kind of snug and fitted, but some people love this fit and I kind of do. And the best thing about it is that I'm personally currently cutting, so I'm probably losing probably another 7 to 10 pounds in the next few weeks. So for that being said, this will fit me perfectly once I've gone down. Like even now, to be honest, it still hugs the sleeves on my arms. The clothing itself feels comfortable. It feels nice and snug, and the best thing about it, I feel warm. Let's check out the hoodie. The hoodie could be bigger in my opinion, because the hoodies on the pullovers are quite big and kind of fit your head. This is kind of small hoodie. So that's the only drawback I can really say about it. But I do have that kind of boxy and Rocky vibes there. Let me try it with like a hat on so you guys can see the difference, if I can find a hat. Ooh, a red hat, that's perfect. So, to be honest, with the hat on, it doesn't look too bad, but on its own, I don't think it feels the best. But yeah, that is a kind of review now. So I'll do like a little summary montage, but overall, this is all the stuff I've got. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with the purchases that I made. Hopefully those of you that watch this video are just trying to give an inclination whether MYPROTEIN stuff's decent or just a size and quality review. I'm giving it the two thumbs up. I really feel like the clothing is really good and they match up to many other big brands out there, and they are a fraction of the price, especially if you use their discounts or my discount if theirs isn't running. Trust me, you are going to make savings, and best of all, you still look good. Like, you can't say any of the stuff that I bought today didn't look good. And this is just the items that I chose. If you go on the website, they have loads and loads and loads more. But I just wanted to make sure that you guys that like bodybuilding on a budget know that you don't have to break the bank and go buy the most expensive gym clothing out there. I'm not gonna say any of those clothings are bad, because they're not. I've got some of them myself. They are quite nice and they do fit well. But if you're on a budget, definitely think about trying out MyProtein. The stuff's good, like I love this. I will probably say out of the stuff I've bought, this, I think I just love the red, gray and black kind of combo. These two are my favorite purchases that I bought this time around, and I'm really happy with it. Ah, hold up, there's one more bonus item. Here is one of the bonus ones. This is one that I already own, and this is the, I don't even know what it's called. I think it's called a three-quarter zip pullover type thing. And this one is one of my favorites as well that I've previously owned. I'm really happy with it, it fits quite well. This one is a small, so it is quite fitted, but it looks pretty damn good. And I'm a massive fan of MyProtein. I've got loads of their stuff. Like, here's a red pullover I previously got. I've got loads of them in my house. I've got like two other colors. Got gray and blue, but yeah, this is how I usually wear this one. If you watch my YouTube channel, you'll probably see loads of these stuff. But anyways, this is the final bit of the video. All I wanna say is like, comment, subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and let me know below if there's any other items on there that I should probably check out, or any other clothing stuff you'd like to see me do. And be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're brand new. I do loads of fitness vlogs. Basically, I do a whole bunch of different type of videos on my channel, from traveling to vlogging to fitness informational videos to certain reviews of certain products like this stuff. Like, there's loads of stuff on my channel, so be sure to subscribe if you're brand new. Anyways, peace out, stay getting gains, and I'll see you in the next video in a few days' time. Peace.